Hello everyone, this is your host Sharmila and welcome back to another episode of Sharmila's Kitchen. Today I'll be making Moog Musallam. The word Moog means chicken and Musallam means whole. So Moog Musallam is a dish prepared from whole chicken stuffed with eggs and various spices. It is a very rich and succulent dish and tastes amazing when paired with basmati rice, pulao or kulcha. Before starting the recipe, I am going to cut leg piece of chicken and I will show you how soft and tender the chicken is. The chicken is very easy to cut as you can see. I am gonna serve this in another plate and also serve half of the eggs and topped up with onion beresta or brown onions. Some cucumber and onion salad is also good to go. In the first step of the recipe, we have to marinate the chicken very well. Because the whole chicken takes a lot of time to marinate and if you don't marinate it properly, the chicken won't be soft and juicy. So here I have one whole chicken, weighs about 1 kg. Try to take small chicken because small chicken is easy to cook and also tastes very delicious. I prefer to make the Moog Musallam with skin chicken because it holds more moisture and makes the curry juicy. Here you can see the skin is little burnt. Sometimes skin chicken has very tiny feathers and hairs that are very difficult to remove. So if you singe the chicken over with an open flame, it will help to get rid of all those tiny feathers and hairs. And also make sure the chicken is well slitted where the chicken meat is very fat so that the masala can go inside and make the chicken well seasoned. So to make the chicken tenderized, we are going to soak the chicken in brine water. I'm going to be adding about 3 liters of water. 2 teaspoons of salt and soak the chicken in this brine water. Keep the breast side upside down because the breast meat is more tough, so we need to marinate it very well. Now soak the chicken in this brine water for 2 hours. After 2 hours, take out from the water and pat dry the chicken. Make sure all the parts of the chicken are dry and clean. Also remove the excess water from the internal cavity. Now keep this aside and now we will be making very thick and masala dal marinade. So in a big bowl, add turmeric powder. For the ingredients list, you can check the description below. I have also added red chili powder, ginger garlic paste, yogurt, tandoori masala powder. It will really make this Moog Musallam very amazing. Cumin powder, garam masala powder. Give a gentle mix. Now I'm going to be adding lemon juice, refined oil, salt, very tiny amount of food color. It is completely optional. If you don't like, don't use it. Now give it a final mix and apply this thick marinade on the chicken. Make sure you apply this marinade on the slits and all the other parts of the chicken. Now the chicken is coated with masala. Let it rest for another 1 hour. After 1 hour, we have to truss the chicken very nicely. So using a kitchen twine, tie the wings first. As you can see how I am doing it. First tie the wings and then give it a knot on the top part of the breast. And now inside the cavity, I am gonna be adding 2 hard boiled eggs, some potato cubes and coriander. We'll make this herb will make the Moog Musallam very flavorful. Now bring the twine around towards the legs. Make sure the string is very tightly kept to force the wings firmly against the body. Now bring the kitchen twine around between leg and breast, then give it one overhand knot and pull it very tightly. And now the wings will be solidly pinned to the body and the chicken breast will pop up. Just like this. And now I'm bringing the ends of the twine down between the chicken legs. Give a twist knot around the legs Now cross the legs and tie the ankles. Make sure you put the knot very tightly. Cut the extra twine. Now heat 1 tablespoon of oil in a pan. In this pan add 10 to 15 almonds. Fry it for 1 minute. Then add raisins about 20 to 25. So when the raisins are nicely popped up, take them off. Now put these fried almonds and raisins in a grinder jar. Also add golden fried onions or onion beresta. Add little bit of water and make a paste out of it and keep it aside. So to make the darbari moong musallam very flavorful, here in a cup of milk I'm gonna be adding 2 to 3 drops of meetha atar, and if you don't have meetha atar you can replace it with a keura water, or you can also add the combination of meetha atar and keura water. Just give a gentle mix and keep this also ready. In the same pan add about 1 cup of oil, because now we are going to fry the whole chicken in this oil, so the oil should be more. So to make the oil flavorful, I am gonna be adding little bit like 1 teaspoon of ghee. So when the oil is hot, add the whole chicken. Also make sure in which you are going to make the whole chicken, that pot is very big enough to feed the chicken. Trussing the chicken is very important so that the part of the chicken are intact and the egg stuffing couldn't able to come out. First cook the chicken on high flame for 10 minutes, then make the flame low and keep cooking it for 40 minutes until the chicken is tender. And also make sure you turn over the chicken so all the part of the chicken cooked evenly, and also cook the sides of the chicken. Insert a toothpick or knife in the breast to check the chicken is done or not. So the chicken is done now. When the chicken is done, the skin of the chicken will be crunchy and the inside will be soft. Now let's make the gravy. To make the chicken gravy, we don't need so much oil. Take out most of the oil. In this less amount of oil, we are going to make the gravy. We will use the leftover marinade from the chicken for the gravy. So in the hot oil, add leftover marinade, and this marinade is very flavorful because it has all the masalas. So cook this masala for 3 to 4 minutes or until the masala and oil got separated. So when the leftover marinade is cooked nicely, add almond, raisins and fried onion paste which we already made previously. Now also cook it for another 3 to 4 minutes until the oil flows on the top. After 3 to 4 minutes, add flavored milk and keep the flame low. In the meantime, transfer the whole chicken in a big serving platter and also cut the kitchen twine. Now pour the gravy on the whole roasted chicken, and now it is ready to serve with any kind of flavorful rice, kulcha, naan or roti. I hope you guys enjoyed watching this recipe. If you like this recipe, please give this a thumbs up. Share with your family and friends, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel.